This could be all just a dream. I could open my eyes and everything could seem back as it was and back as it used to be. I don't truthfully remember what the first song I ever wrote was, because when I was a kid, I started writing songs when I was 13 years old, but I do remember the first one that made any kind of difference. I wrote a song when I was in high school, probably around 16 or 17. I was attempting to woo a woman who was a year older than me, and she walked in thinking she was just grabbing papers to take back down to her teacher, and I played that song for her, which is like probably one of the scariest moments of my entire life as a 15 or 16 year old probably. And we ended up dating for like a year until she went to college. And that was a big deal for me. It was the first time I ever did discover the power of being a guitar player and a singer-songwriter. I discovered the guitar under the steps of the second floor staircase in the pre-Civil War house that I grew up in as a kid, just outside of Leesburg. And I was an only child. I grew up in the country. I didn't have any, you know, brothers or sisters, cousins, anything like that nearby. Our closest neighbors were chickens and cows. And so for me to discover an instrument like the guitar was amazing, because I immediately started writing just like little songs and journaling all the time. And it was an amazing way for me to be creative in a world where I didn't have that outlet until that moment. Whenever I had a job, whenever I was supposed to be studying for school, whenever I was supposed to be responsible at anything else, was when I was always most creative. And so now, as a full-time musician, I have to like put myself in the position of doing things I don't want to do so I can, you know, daydream and think about songs and stuff. Usually has to do now nowadays as an adult with doing your taxes. You sit down, you try to do your taxes, and you write five songs. I think songwriting for me has always been kind of sitting down, noodling on the guitar, thinking about a phrase, and something kind of like a phoenix, something like emerges from the ashes. I have a song that I'm gonna play tonight called All the Places That I've Been that I wrote over the course of a year. I wrote all at once one night, and then a year later I figured out how to finish it. And it was really one of the first songs that I'd ever done like that, where I did not feel right just winging the end. Like I knew that it wasn't done, and I was just gonna back away, and however much time needed to go by, went by. I wrote all the places that I've been because I grew up with my grandmother. She was my only grandparent, and I was her only grandchild, and we were very close. Her name was Lenore. And my grandmother had amazing stories as a kid. She was born in 1919. The horse and buggy still existed. The car was just becoming a thing. Her parents owned a hotel where her mother, Zula, would cook for the entire town. They had bought her a baby grand piano, and they had big French doors, and people would come from miles around to eat Zula's food. They would open the French doors, and my grandmother would play piano for them. And I wanted to do my part in helping preserve that feeling of that time. And I wrote that song called All the Places That I've Been about a fictional gentleman in real history experiencing all the things that my grandmother and all of our grandparents experienced. Like I said, I wrote the first half of that song about his fictional life, and then the last half of that song, it actually, if you think about it in terms of a fork, his personal narrative goes one direction, and the story that I tell is what's happening in real life while his life is happening.
All right, let me know when you're ready.
Ready?
Oh, ready, okay.
And I feel my mind is failing, and I think my skin is growing thin. Wonder if I'll remember all those places I've been. And I ain't walked tall in ages, my back just don't bend that way. And my hair was once receding, but now it's all gone away. I was born in Oklahoma on a farm outside of town. And I spent my days out wandering in the fields behind our house. And I wondered what was out there beyond the fences of our home. And I left town for the army when I turned 18 years old. And I remember what it felt like as I raced on to the shore. The cool breeze and the salt air on June 6th, 1944. And I watched my friends get mowed down by the Mausers on the hill. And I don't know how I made it, but I thank God that I did. Myself near D.C. when the war was finally done, and I got myself a family and a wife and three young little ones. And I ran for public office, becoming mayor of my town. And my parents stood right by me, and my wife said she was proud. We lived through the Truman Doctrine as Jackie took the field. And the Rosenbergs were sentenced and segregation was repealed. And Rosa sat in silence and Elvis sang a song. And the Cuban Missile Crisis marked the final days of John. And the Beatles crossed the ocean, and Dr. King was shot and killed. Oh, and Nixon left his office, oh, as the radio star was killed. And the Challenger exploded on Oklahoma Pride. And 13 people died by two troubled kids in Columbine. I feel my mind is failing, and I think my skin is growing thin. And I wonder if I'll remember all those places I have been.
For years, my band was the Justin Trawick Group. There was never really a band name, but we would perform live as the Justin Trawick Group. Sometime around like 2014 or 15, my sound started getting a little bit more defined and I wanted to be a little bit more purposeful of what we were doing. And I was trying to think of like a band name that would somehow give an allusion to Virginia, because that's where I'm from. And I looked up what Commonwealth meant in Wikipedia, and it meant to do something for the common good. All my songs start out as a singer-songwriter song, just me on my, you know, bed at 2:30 in the morning, writing songs in my boxers and a t-shirt. And I bring the songs to the band, and everybody puts their own flair on it. Five and Dime is, it's my song, but it's a collaborative effort in the sense of like they're kind of doing their own thing. Everything that you hear from them are things that are coming out of their own brain, out of their own fingers. I have surrounded myself with much more talented musicians that I love and are so good at storytelling in an instrumental way. I think a lot of the songs that I've written are from the position of doing something with your life. I have a bunch of songs that have like vignettes. Each verse is about a different person who is struggling in some sort of way. Five and Dime is just really like, you know, you're driving down the street with your top down of your convertible, and you are on the way to get something done.
One, two, three, four. To the south side, gotta hand it to them, they were right on the first try. We got those big dreams swinging from the roof beams. I tell you all about it when I show up in my hoopty. I never told you where I think I'm really going, cause I never had a reason yet to show you my hand, but check it. Now or never, baby, baby, now or never, baby. Come on, come on, close around and give you my plan. Now, goddamn, look at my life, standing on the corner of a five and dime. Looking over my shoulder, living every day like it's my last. Oh hell, how do I tell friend or foe when you just don't know? I hope I'll make it through the day, but for now I'll just sit for today. It's calling, I got about a full of Hennessy, now you're starving, darling. We got a fire sale, everything must go quick, quick. Got the door ready, set, go! Running away from me, stopping like a centipede. Gotta make room for the fresh new improved me. And every day is a gift that you throw away. Dug up by another man, tries to run a rainy day. Goddamn, look at my life, standing on the corner of a five and nine. Looking over my shoulder, living every day like it's my last. Oh hell, how do I tell friend or foe when you just don't know? I hope I'll make it through the day, but for now I'll just sit for today. My shoulder, flipping every day like it's my last. Oh hell, how do I tell friend or foe when you just don't know? I hope I'll make it through the day, but for now I'll just sit for today.
I'm very close to my parents. I'm an only child. My parents are my only immediate family, and in a normal world, I talk to my parents daily. I see them usually at least once a week, and so when the coronavirus happened, the pandemic happened, we had to not just social distance, but in the beginning, we just were distanced, right? I didn't see them for 4 or 5 months, and I didn't see friends. You know, people as a full-time musician, having a band, seeing people at a concert. Running the 9 songwriter series, which is always me and 8 other different singer-songwriters every show, I'm used to seeing hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people a year, or maybe thousands, to suddenly only seeing, you know, the person that you live with and maybe your neighbors. I wrote Back of the Line as, you know, one of those songs about missing the feeling of being around people. I think that this was such a dramatic time in my life that I really did write about it. I wrote a song about the feeling of missing, you know, the feeling of human touch and the feeling of sun on your face. And I wrote that song, I started playing it on Facebook Live for people, and they actually encouraged me to record it because they liked it so much. That was not my intention, especially during a difficult time like this where you really can't record very easily. I was lucky enough to actually get Back of the Line featured in, exclusively featured in Parade magazine. As a kid, I used to read Parade magazine every Sunday. It came as like the insert in the Washington Post. And it was really cool. It was American Songwriter wrote about it. You know, I'd never gotten any press before in my life. And then, you know, I wrote that song and people just really kind of liked it. I can't wait to play it more for people in person. You know, we're still obviously locked down. So one day, you know, it'll be nice to be able to play in front of live people that song again.
Just a dream, and I could open my eyes and everything would seem back as it was, back as it used to be. I want to tell you the truth, and I've never been more afraid to lose the people I know and the things we used to do. Running backwards, fading fast, back of the line, back of the line, back of the line again. Leaning into wind that's blowing me back of the line, back of the line, back of the line again. I can remember every single thing. I want to feel the sun, and I want to reach out my arms and simply touch someone, or I'd just settle for their face. Leaning into wind truth, and I've never been more afraid to lose the people I know and the things we used to do. Growing thin, and I wonder if I'll remember all those places I have been. And I ain't walked tall in ages, my back just don't bend that way. And my hair was once receding, and now it's all gone away.
Dreams from an ordinary day have never been as vivid as today. I can remember every single thing. I want to feel the sun. I want to reach out my arm and simply touch someone, or I just settle for their face.